Everyone, a quick video about, well, basically replying to a question of why civilians should train with a tactical vest. And I think that, you know, it's really up to each and every person as to whether or not they want to. Some will see it as very unnecessary. Some who consider themselves as preppers, like myself, like to put themselves through a variety of situations, pressure test themselves, and see how adaptable they can become to the situation and or their environment. So, myself, I think there's a lot of merit in running vests, not only because it's convenient to put your stuff on you and whatever else. Basically, you can carry all your shit. And, you know, the other thing that I'll get to later on, I'll expand on that later on, or elaborate on that later on. But basically, the other thing is that it's restrictive. It's heavy. It's weighted. So I think that any, not so much limitation, but challenge you put on yourself during training is another form of another step in the process of pressure testing, or another level of pressure testing, in other words. And I think that that has great merit, always challenging yourself. So in terms of vests, look, I've got a couple of plate carriers here. I've got mine in tan and another one here in black. And I've got everything the same. I run different sort of things on different rigs. But at the same time, I'll just chuck that there for now. But at the same time, I like to have the same setup once I become comfortable with it. Now, like I said, it's good to be able to train with these things because it's convenient and also the restrictive aspect. But one thing I'm going to mention real quick here is that these guys can actually double up as a go bag. And it's up to you how far you want to go with your prepping and everything, and your preparations, based on your own belief and what other people may call your level of paranoia, what I like to call preparation and or thinking ahead, planning ahead. But if you feel that you may someday come under threat from whatever it may be, you know, your country or your area, whatever may be invaded, you might be, you know, victim of circumstance due to civil war or whatever. Here in Japan, we actually are surrounded by North Korea, China, Russia, and everyone is kind of fucked off at us and threatening to invade or threatening war, threatening to, and they have fired missiles over us before. So again, it's always been in the back of my mind, like, what if one day we're invaded? Do I know how to use every single tool with efficiency, not just effectiveness, but efficiency, minimum effort, maximum effect? And can I run things the way I would need to in a high risk environment, you know, under stress, under pressure, and still be functional and, again, efficient? The point is that I'd like to make, that is a really good point that I believe in, is that these double up as a go bag. Okay, as I was saying before, these actually double up as one. So instead of this hydration kit that I put on the back here, I can actually put, this is a little day bag that I get my RSOs, the range safety officers, to run. And it is actually a hydration carrier, but there's enough, you know, room up the top for first aid gear, anything else, snacks, fucking books, notes, cameras, whatever. The point is that I can have my go bag on the back of my vest, and, you know, you could put plates in there for protection, whatever, or you could just attach all your shit. You could attach your first aid kit. I've got that on my battle belt over there. I'll show that in a second. First aid kit. If you've got a gun, which a lot of you do, obviously, because you're watching this, but you can attach your different sort of mounts to it, okay? Different holsters. I've got custom holsters here. I just did a review sort of introduction video on that, so definitely check that out. But just real quickly, as I said in another video that you can check out also on our online learning database and or site, is that, you know, these Defender plate carriers I really like because you can put whatever you want on them, okay? They're just a base with your molly platform there that you can really put anything on. Things that are like, for example, this one, different types of vests where it's already decided where everything is, I think are not as effective because you don't have free sort of, shit, free sort of range of options, whereas this one does. However, you can't actually put plates in it, okay? So it's got molly compatible system just about everywhere, all over front, back, and sides, and all the rest. But unlike this, okay, I can't actually slip plates in there on the front, back, and sides. And this has got great insulation and everything. So like I said, if the shit did hit one day hit the fan, you know, I could be preparing by putting the back, the bag on the back of that, okay, with my hydration kit as usual as always in there, but also other things, tools, food, the survival kit essentials, the emergency kit essentials and whatever else. So it's just an idea. I think that it's very important to think outside the box all the time. The thing is not to be so narrow-minded, single-minded or arrogant, because really that's what's going to blind you in terms of your potential or possibilities, you know, your opportunities for actual survival. You know, you're not going to be able to recognize the chances that are the opportunities that are right there in front of you in situations. So your ability to improvise, adapt and overcome is always through, you know, I think based on your awareness. And awareness can be developed through not just knowledge but experience, you know, training in a variety of environments, in a variety of scenarios and situations, and with a variety of tools, or circumstances, or limitation of tools, or limited amount of tools. So, you know, this is just one option. This is something I train and I got them to, you know, see how it goes when I'm running gear like that, and also be able to relate to our student body, which a lot of them are military, law enforcement, security, private contractors, whatever. And like I said, it's convenient for me on the range to have all my shit on me. So I have used these. I do think they have great merit, and even as a civilian, I think that if you are sort of one of those who call ourselves a prepper, then I believe that they can have great value, because they do, again, have that multi-purpose sort of double up of being a go bag. All I gotta do is grab that and run. And once I'm out the door, even I could be slipping this over the top of me while I'm outside. I don't have to put it on and then run. I can just grab it and go and put it on when I can. So, or you can put it on when you're being invaded if you think that your house is gonna be invaded or whatever. So it really is up to you. But again, having more options really does increase your chances of survival in any sort of high risk scenario, environment, and or situation. So thank you for watching. If you haven't already subscribed, check out our online learning at rawcombat.com. A lot of survivalist videos. A lot of tactical training, martial arts, combative, self-protection, even for women and kids, and also obviously Yojimbo fight gear. So also follow us on Facebook. We've got a lot of good discussions going on there. Myself, Luke Holloway, Raw Combat International again, and even RCI Tactical. So thanks for watching, and as always, stay hard to kill.